Hello students, in my last previous videos I explained the topic called Introduction to Accounting, Journal Entries Posting and Ledger Accounts. In this video I am going to explain the topic called Trial Balances. Before starting this video, still if you are not subscribed my channel means please subscribe my channel. Let me start today's session. Let me know first what is trial balance. A trial balance is a sheet records all ledger balances categorized into debit and credit. See here, I mentioned that here accounts will make a ledger taking all the ledger balances and presenting them in a single worksheet. So in the trial balance, we will take all the ledger balances and we record in the trial balance. For clear understanding of concept, let's say you record all your activities in a diary. At month end, you summarize your diary and classified into any various categories. Now you make a sheet and divide the categories into productive and non-productive items. That's exactly what the business are doing. So businesses records the transactions in journal and summarize the transaction and record them in ledger and classify the ledgers into any trial balances. So here, whatever the ledger balances, we will carry forward to any trial balances. So in the trial balances, there is any two aspects. One is any debit aspect and one other is any credit aspect. In debit aspect, we will record all assets and expenditures. In credit aspect, we will record all liabilities and incomes. Before going in depth in this concept, let me see what are the advantages we are having for any trial balance. The first advantage, the trial balance lists all the accounts as any particular date. The debit total of any trial balance must matches with any credit totals. So the trial balance is an indicator of the arithmetical accuracy of any books of account. And next advantage is a trial balance is a summary sheet listed all ledger balances. For that sake, we can call it as a bird's eye view. The third advantage is the organizations needs to know the profit or loss or financial position of every year. To know the financial position, the prerequisite is a trial balance. And next advantage is the trial balance offers significant comfort regarding the accuracy. And next one is for purpose of audit, the trial balance is a help for analyze the sheets. The trial balance is also used by bankers and the lending agencies to understand the borrowing capacity of any business. These are the advantages of any trial balance. So in the trial balance, there is two aspects, debit and then credit. In the debit side, we will record all the assets and then liabilities. And in the credit side, we will record all incomes and the incomes. The assets are nothing but, what are the assets means? Which we will get the value for any long period of any time. For an example, land, building, cash in hand, cash in bank, machinery, vehicles, these are the assets. And what are the expenditures? The expenditures are nothing but whatever things we are purchased. We are spend money for getting something into an a business. That all things we can call it as an expenses. For example, purchase a stationery item is an expenditure, and purchase some goods, it's an expenditure, or we paid telephone bill or any transport bill is an expenditure for any business. And coming to the liabilities, The liability is nothing but which the business is going to pay. Liable to pay means repayment of any money. We can call it as any liability. So capital is any liability. Bank loan is any liability. In the bank loan means a short-term loan and the long-term loan, they are the liabilities. And bills payables is any liability. Creditor is any liability. Means which are to pay. Which are to pay, which are to give is any liabilities. And coming to the incomes. If we received discount or if you received interest and if you received rent, whatever the coming aspect, inside aspect, we can call it as any incomes. So in the trial balance, we will record all assets and expenditures in any debit side, and we'll record all credit item means liabilities and incomes in any credit side. So let me start with any problem. So this is a ledger account which I did in the last previously video. So these are the credit, these are the cash account, this is a cash ledger account. So the cash account, and this is any balances which are carry forward for any future, means closing balances. Cash account and then closing balances. Capital account and then closing balances. Like this, this is a previous video problem, ledger problem, ledger posting. Now by using this ledger postings, we are going to do the trial balances. See, in the previous itself I told that we will post all ledger balances into any trial balances, means ledger account balances in the trial balances. When we post all ledger balances into trial balance, the debit total must and should be equals to any credit total. Let me start the posting of trial balance by using the ledger balances. So before posting that, we will see the what's the pro forma or format of any trial balance. This is the this format is similar like any journal entry pro forma. So in the journal entry, there will be any date column, particulars, LF, debit and the credit. But in trial balance, there is any serial number. Here there is a no date column. Is there a serial number and name of the account? See, you will get one doubt. What's the name of any account? Means here, whatever the ledger account names, we can call it as any name of any account. So we will post all ledger balances into any trial balance. Okay, let me start. So this is the first, we'll post cash account. Here it is in a cash account. This is a name of any ledger account, one of the ledger account. This is a cash ledger account. So the cash account, the balances is in debit side. See, two balance brought down, 1,30,000, means it is in the debit side. So if you want to learn the ledger, how to post the ledger accounts, means in the description box I given the link of any journal entries and ledger posting. So please go through that video, then you can able to know what's the ledger, where the debit means left hand side is in a debit place and the right hand place is any credit. So if you are not clear about the ledger posting, means please go through with that videos. So this is a cash account. Then the cash account, the balance is on the debit side. So first we'll post the cash account. The cash account, the final balance is in the debit side. Let me point highlights. Let high. See, the cash account, the closing balance or happen in the debit side. Okay, now we will post this cash account in the trial balance. So this is the trial balance. Okay, so here we don't have any name, a date. So first we'll give as any serial number as any one. So previous was the account, means it is any cash account. The cash account is any debit balance. So it is any 1,30,000. And next, see, we completed cash account with any debit balances. Now we'll go with any capital account. See, the capital account is any, we can see the closing balance on credit side. Okay, capital account 1 lakh rupee on credit side. Capital account 1 lakh rupee on credit side. So let me post in the trial balance. So second one is any capital account, and it was in the balances, closing balances is in the credit side. So now we'll write in the credit side. Go with any next ledger account is any furniture account. The furniture account and the balances will be in the debit side. See, it will be in debit side. So we'll post the furniture account in debit side with any 7,000 rupees. See, third serial number furniture account in the debit side. Here we wants to place the amount, there's a 7,000. See the next account. The next account is any land account. The balance brought down will be in the debit side with an amount of any 20,000 rupees. So we'll post in the trial balance. The fourth one is any land account with an amount in the debit side as any 20,000 rupees. And the next account, ledger account, is any accounts payable. And the balance is any credit side. The balance is in the credit side. So we'll paste account payable account in the credit side with amount of any 20,000 rupees. So fifth one, accounts payable with credit side 20,000 rupees. And next account is any sales account. Sales account. The balance is appearing in the credit side. The balance brought down with any 1 lakh rupee. So we'll post the sales account in the credit side with any 1 lakh rupee. So sixth one, sales account with amount of 1 lakh rupee in credit side. We'll see the next item. Next is any accounts receivable. And the opening balances are appearing in, the balance brought down was appearing in debit side with amount of any 60,000 rupees. Now we'll post the accounts receivable account in the debit side with amount of any 60,000 rupees. So seventh is an accounts receivable in the debit side, means debit column, is for any 60,000 rupees. And the next account we'll see, the next account is any salary expenses account. It was in the debit side with amount of any, the balances with any 2,000 rupees. We'll post. Eighth one is any salary expenditure account with amount of any 2,000 rupees. And the next ledger account is any transport expenses account. The transport expenses account balances are showing in the debit side. The balance brought down is in the debit side with our 1,000 rupees. Now we'll post transport expenses account, the debit side, with amount of any 1,000 rupees. The ninth one, transport expenses or expenditure, debit side, 1,000 rupees. Like this, we will post all the ledger balances in the trial balances. The biggest task is here we want to balance them. Here the debit balance must and should be equals to a credit. So if you total all the debit balances, means you will get the 2,20,000. So in the credit side also you want to get the same amount, 2,20,000. If you are not get the same amount, means some error was occurred in journal posting or any ledger posting. So if the two balances are matches, then only we'll go for any preparation of final statements. If it is not, means again we wants to open the suspense account or we wants to cross check the where mistake was happened. So if in this problem the credit total is also 2,20,000. So like this, we will post all the ledger balances in the trial balances. What's the main use of any trial balance, means here we can able to identify the mistakes. And here it helps for smooth flow of any analyzing where the expenses are happening more and where we are getting the income more. So hope guys, today you understand the topic well. Thank you.